Quickly, want to look at how you prepare double column cash book. In the last video, we were able to see how to apply double entry principle in preparing a cash book, single column cash book. Now, we'll be using the same principle in preparing this one, and there's no difference, no much difference between the two. The only difference is the inclusion of a back column, another column for amounts. Then you only use a column for amount. Here now, we have divided the column into two. That is cash and bank, which means this particular business is using both cash and bank. They collect money from people, cash, and they also collect check. They allow check. That's the implication. Okay, but we'll be focusing more on the major reason why we do this is the what we call contra entries. What we call contra entries, as we have it here, in May 19 and May 15, cash paid into the bank and cash withdrawn from bank for business use. Those are the instances of contra entries that you can actually have. Now, without wasting time, they say write up the double column cash book from the following. So we have transactions for the month of May. On May 1st, what happened? They are having, you know, some money in the bank and some money in the business at hand. And that is what this means. They say balance brought down. The balance brought down here means the amount, the balances they were having at the end of April. So they are bringing it forward into the month of May. That's the meaning. So what do we do? That means the business is having the money, so it comes to the debit side. So you have May 1, call it balance brought forward. Okay, it's from May, it's coming from April. 560 cash and 23,560 bank in the bank. May 2nd, the business is paying for rent. It's paying check for rent. So that means it will be credited. May 2, they're paying for rent. You put rent here. What are they paying? Check. So that means it will come under bank. How much? 400. Then, May 3rd, they paid for postage. Paying for postage. So it's still coming to the credit side. What did they pay for? Postage. So you put it under particulars. Is it check? Oh, cash. How much? 50 naira. You put. Then, May 10, cash sales. They sold some goods and they collected cash, okay, of 740 naira. So that is coming here because money is coming in. Money is coming in here. So you call it sales. Sales. How much? 740. Since it is cash, so we put it under cash. May 11, cash drawings by proprietor. 200 naira. So the proprietor is drawing from the business. He's taking money from the business. So is money coming out of the business or money is going out? Money is leaving the business. That's the meaning. Money is leaving the business. So you record it on the credit side. May 11, you call it drawings. Remember your private ledger. This is an example of a private ledger. Okay? The owner is the one taking money from the business. 200 naira cash. It's a cash. Then, May 15, cash paid into bank. This is an example of contra entry. And contra entries, you record them. You have two accounts in an entry, in a transaction. Okay? And the two accounts are to be recorded separately, normally. But in this case, the two of them will be recorded in the same book, in the same cash book. One will receive a debit, the other one will receive a credit. So, when they say cash paid into the bank, what does that mean? Cash is going into the bank. The business is putting the money they have realized for that day, putting it into the bank. So the bank is receiving it. What will you now do? Since bank is receiving a debit bank, then you now credit cash. What does that now mean? You now say May 15, cash paid into bank. Bank is receiving it. So which means bank will be debited. The column for bank will be debited. So you now say cash here. We use C to denote contra entry. So you put it in the folio, okay? 600 under bank. 600 under bank. So the corresponding entry will now come here, May 15. Cash is going out, going into the bank. So you put bank here, and you record the amount inside under cash column, 600 naira. I want to believe that is clear. So you can watch that part again if it's not that clear, so that you get it. Next one, May 17. We paid
Obaloluwa by check. We, the business is paying Obaloluwa, which means the business is giving. May 17, the business is giving who? Obaloluwa. Who is Obaloluwa to the business? Obaloluwa is a creditor. They are owing him. Obaloluwa is a creditor here. So 750 bank. Then May 19, withdrew 2,000 from bank for business. So the business needed money, some money, and they had to go to the bank to get the money. Okay? Now, what is happening here? They are withdrawing money from the bank. This is also an example of contra entry. So the money is leaving the bank and it's coming into the business in form of cash. So that means you will debit cash and credit bank. May 19, you are debiting cash, right? So that means the bank will be here. Contra. How much? 2,000 under cash. You come here again, May 19. You are crediting bank here. So that means cash will be the particulars. And you come under bank to put the 2,000. That is contra entry. So you debit one and you credit the other one. Okay? The two will be recorded in the same book. Then the last one, May 21. Enora paid us 1,500 cash. Enora is paying the business. We are not the one paying now. So which means money is coming in. So May 21st, Enora is paying us. So we put Enora. Who is Enora here? Enora is a debtor. He's owing us. So he has come. She has come to pay us. How much? That is cash. 1,500. Then we are done. So the next thing is to balance this book. Balancing of accounts. That's the level we are now, or the stage we are. So you just total like this. Add the total of this, all of this together. Whatever it gives you, add this one, two together. Whatever it gives you, you now minus from the, you minus the one that is lesser from the one that is more. So here we have 0, 0, 10. This is 6. 6 plus 7, that's 13, plus 5, 8. So we have 4,800. Okay? So if we add this, this will give us 800. 850 naira. So minus 850 naira from this. This is more than this one. So just say 4,800 minus 860, 50 naira. EF, 0, 5 from 10. 5. So 8 from 7. 8 from 7 we give you 9. Then we have 3,950. So here we have the total of this 0, 6, 11, 24. So we total this also. This will give us 3,150. 3,150. Minus 3,150 from this. 3,150 from this. 0. 5 from 6. 1. 1 from 1. 0. Then 3 from 24. 21. And that's all. So you now say May 31st, the last day of the month. Balance carry down. This is the balance carried out. So you now come here and say June 1st. That was what happened here. They brought the balances of April to May. So you are taking the balances for this month of May to June, to continue in the month of June. So now say balance brought down 4,800 and then 21,010 naira. And that is... There's a mistake there. The balance we have there is 3,950 and not 4,800. And that is all. I want to believe this is clear. You know, if it is not clear, please take your time to go over it. I believe you will understand. Thank you.